Hello, PEG community. I'm here to speak to you today as valued employees, trusted partners, and my dear friends. I personally want to update you on the impacts of the coronavirus and the steps we are taking to respond to it. As you know, effects on business, economies, and the entire world are unprecedented. Impacts are more sudden and more severe than any previous downturn in my 17-year history at PEG. In less than a week, the virus has shut down almost the entire economy. My heart aches for my colleagues and my fellow community members whose businesses were forced to be closed as a result of the virus. But my message for you today is PEG Companies remains open and operational. Over the last 2 weeks, we have implemented new critical policies and procedures that will position PEG to be able to weather this environment. We are prepared, we have a plan, and we are now executing on that plan. So let's talk about what PEG is doing right now to combat the virus, starting with the health and well-being of our community. Our number one priority is to keep our people safe. That's why as soon as the coronavirus hit our region, we took immediate measures. We waived PTO for employees for illnesses and family illnesses. We suspended non-essential business travel. We implemented extended waiting periods for those employees that had traveled outside the country before coming to work. And we encouraged work from home by implementing technologies and video conferencing for those employees and encouraged them to work from home. And as of today, there are no reports of anybody testing positive for that virus. The last 2 weeks have been two of the hardest weeks of my career as a CEO. As a CEO, you're in a position to encourage and build your employees and be the leader of an organization to help it succeed. Due to external circumstances with this virus and the crisis that we have, we've had to do employee layoffs that have had nothing to do with these employees or their performance. We've also implemented a company-wide pay reduction, starting with the C-team employees with a 30% reduction. The manager level between 20 and 25% reduction, and all other employees a 10% reduction. We believe these cuts will not be long-term. As we have talked to our employees, they told us they understand the necessary sacrifice for the cuts and the future success of our business, and we thank them for that. Now, let's talk about our investments. As you know, the asset class that was hit the hardest was the hospitality sector. PEG manages and operates over 4,900 rooms across U.S. and Canada through in-group hospitality of PEG Company. Over the last few weeks, we have taken measures in the company to evaluate each one of those properties and how the property operates and a major cost reduction. We continue to manage that cost reduction in each property, and we monitor it daily with our staff from a cash position and from an operations position. We take that information and we roll it up and we try to manage where we're at in each one from an overall cash position. And we try on a weekly basis to report to our investors what the situation is in each one of those properties for them to anticipate a need for capital. As part of that plan, we're also working with the banks and the lenders on trying to manage the debt and extend debt out so we can get through the operations to keep each property open. We believe this decrease in tourism and travel is temporary. As COVID-19 flattens out and the economy comes back online, we expect tourism and business travel not only to return to its normal levels, but even possibly exceed those levels as people reschedule the travel they postponed during the outbreak. PEG's other asset classes, multifamily, medical office, industrial, retail, and student housing are currently not nearly as distressed as the hospitality sector. These other asset classes may experience slowdown due to the overall effects of the economy. We may have slow lease-up periods or a slow growth in rent, but there is still demand and our PEG properties are well insulated. Now the current projects in construction are continuing to move forward. People are on site and schedules are still being met. On the new development side of the business where we had projects in the pipeline that are ready to start construction are still moving forward. Banks are still making loans. We're seeing some benefits from a slowdown in the economy for pricing and schedules being accelerated. As we look at what happened in 2008 and 2009 in the last downturn, we feel like there's opportunities for us from the the changing environment as properties may have more distress, and PEG has been positioned to take unique opportunities and benefit from them. And we plan to do that once again. During a time plagued with uncertainty around every corner, PEG is preparing for every scenario. But be assured, PEG is moving forward. We have weathered downturns before, and we'll do it again. PEG has always taken a conservative approach, leveraged debt appropriately, paced ourselves, diversified across asset classes and geographies, and most importantly, stuck to our principles. And these experiences will make us even stronger as an organization and a community. For example, as we are positioning our hotels and how to do the layoffs and the cost cutting, we've given some autonomy to the general managers to run those properties and see what the business plan is and have more direct impact on that business plan. And as they do that in this tough environment, we believe that as we come through this, they'll know more now how to operate in a good environment as they've gone through the stress of the challenging environment. Keep in mind, we're already seeing work resume in China where the outbreak happened. President Trump is vowing to reopen the U.S. economy sooner than later. And PEG already is preparing to take advantage of the $2 trillion relief bill. We are well positioned, and we will come out of this ahead. In the meantime, take care of yourselves, take care of your families, and know we're all in this together as we continue to protect our people and our investments.